Welcome back for another video in our series. Today we'll discuss about how to approach specific problems during your PhD. First of all, I would like to say that a PhD is a marathon, is not a sprint. It takes time until you develop an idea, you work on it, you prove that it works, and of course then that you produce something novel. So it's not gonna be a few months' time work like a project in your bachelor's or master's degree, but it will take 3-4 years. Sometimes a PhD look like that you cannot see the end of the tunnel. You're a bit alone, you're isolated, and you feel anxiety. Anxiety is very common for PhD students, especially for those who are working alone, they're trying hard, and they're a bit isolated. If you are a PhD student who doesn't belong in a large group of researchers supervised under the same supervisor, the next tips are especially good for you. First of all, I will start with do not get discouraged. There are a lot of solutions, a lot of ways that you can improve the life during the PhD. So here are my next 5 tips. Number one, work smart and ask your peers for support, especially all of you who are not part of a large group, as I said before. You may want to ask other PhD students from other supervisors to get a better idea of how other supervisors are guiding their PhD students. You may want to even join some community, some forum, where you can exchange ideas, ways of approaching specific problems, methodologies, and if the PhDs of the other students are also similar to yours, maybe even share and exchange a few specific ideas. Tip number two. You are not going to solve all the problems of the PhD in one day. Be well organized and methodical and try to attempt the PhD step by step. Assign some milestones and celebrate every single time you manage to successfully complete one. Tip number three, be prepared for the unforeseen events because they will happen. Always allow for the contingency plan and a bit of extra time. So in the case that something goes wrong, you have already allocated that time and you can work on that without being excessively stressed. Well, and if you are lucky enough not to have any unforeseen events, then you manage to save a bit of time for celebration. Number four, talk to the PGR office and ask for options and resources. They can be very helpful. It is worth to know that there's a plethora of options and resources available at the university. A lot of PhD students, unfortunately, they are not aware of them because they're not really speaking to others and they don't try to look for them. It's not just the PhD supervisor who knows what is available, but is the PGR office itself. Remember, a PhD is not just a project. A PhD is all that experience that you get. Is how to find specific information, is how to search for data, is how to collect things. A PhD is about solving specific difficult questions, solving questions that nobody has solved before, so you need tools and you need resources in order to be able to do it. And after solving those questions, you have to be able to communicate those to other academics and the society with high-level technical terms, as well as being able to actually use layman terms and communicate that to the public. After all, a PhD is a title. You get the lifetime title of being a doctor. So it's all that experience that you're gaining throughout a PhD that is really worth it. For those PhD students who are working on experimental work as well, I would like to say that being in the lab, working with the technicians, organizing everything yourself, that is part of the PhD. So try to gain as much as possible, to really work with people, so there is friction, you're learning, and that is a very, very good asset for all of you who are doing experimental work. It does worth going through that route, and it gives you much more confidence when you're done with the PhD. My number 5 tip is complete the PhD in 3-4 years if possible. Make sure that you're on the game from day one and you are planning and organizing to complete your PhD in time. In other words, in 3 to 4 years, at least for those PhD students who are studying in the UK. I have seen very good PhD projects that are taking much longer, and there is nothing wrong with them as long as both the supervisor and the PhD student is really interested in the project, and of course there is funding available. If you don't have any particular issues like family issues, finance issues, and personal health issues, then I would suggest to work hard and complete the PhD in 3 to 4 years, because that also makes the PhD very timely before someone else is taking over that work. So in other words, make sure that from the time you have done the literature review of your research, you're not extending to more than 3 years after when you start publishing the work, because maybe someone else has already published something that makes your PhD a bit redundant. At the end of the day, there is plenty of time to do work on a PhD, and if a PhD is good, usually there is a lot of things that can be done afterwards that you can do them as a postdoc or as an academic yourself, supervising other PhD students and researchers. One last thing, we're living in an era of information, mass data, and digitalization. There is plenty of data available, and if one source of information doesn't work for you, you can find something else. Also, there is numerous available free online software that you can use to make your PhD better, to present it in a better way, both to other researchers, like when you're attending a conference, or even to the public. I would suggest that you use these tools and resources in order to boost your PhD and ultimately its impact to the society. So to summarize, there are 3 main things. 1, to be prepared for the worst. 2, to create a network of researchers that can help each other and boost the productivity of all of you. 3, search for tools and resources available to flourish your research. And most of all, do not forget to enjoy your PhD. It's not only the destination that matters, but also the trip. If you like these comments, if you find them useful, please hit the like button and subscribe so you can help the algorithm distribute those videos to more PhD candidates and more PhD students who want to learn more about how to conduct a PhD. And if you or they have more comments, you can share them with me. So my next video will be on how to prepare academic presentations for the PhD, during the PhD, for conferences, as well as for when you're attending, as well as for when you are applying for a job. With that said, bye bye all.